Salutations, Celestial Sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, for starters, less hair. More on that in the blog of Eyes on the Sky. With Comet Ison reaching perihelion on the 28th, we'll just have to wait and see if it survives its million miles away sun grazing after swooping close to our star. For now, though, let's swing northward and or overhead in the evening and look to the foot of Andromeda. Much like Alberio in Cygnus, Almac, also known as Gamma Andromedae, has a golden primary star and a blue secondary companion, a lovely double to see. This pair needs a bit more magnification than its summer counterpart, though, as Almac requires 50 to 75 times of magnification to split the 9.6 arc seconds apart components. And most any small telescope can do this fairly easily. What's interesting here is Gamma Andromedae B, the blue component, because that star is itself a double. It has two components orbiting each other once every 68 years, at approximately the Earth-Neptune distance. But there's more. The brighter of those two has another star orbiting it, at a distance so close it takes just 2.7 days to sweep around it, more than 30 times faster than Mercury orbits our Sun. So this double star appearing pair to our eyes is actually a quadruple system. More objects nearby to Almac in a moment. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Want to do something about light pollution but aren't sure how to get started? The International Dark Sky Association has a sample letter you can send to neighbors and tips on talking to them. Follow these guides and start working to reduce light pollution in your neighborhood. Many of us see stars as white, except when they are contrasting like Almac is with its blue and yellow. But seeing yellow and orange colored stars is often only possible when they appear next to each other. Hop from Almac a mere 5 degrees in the direction of Motala, in the oh-so-uniquely named constellation Triangulum, Latin for triangle because, well, it looks like a triangle. We have Ptolemy to thank for that. Anyway, just off that line, less than half a degree, is 56 Andromedae, a 5.7 magnitude star that is in many ways like our Sun, a G-class pale yellow star. Now compare that to the nearby HR 556, a little over 3 arc minutes away, split in a low-power eyepiece. This star, though cooler and 3 times farther away, is nearly the same magnitude at 5.9, and offers us a gorgeous contrast of pale yellow and deep orange color. These stars are definitely worth tracking down. Plus, you can even split them with simple binoculars. However, it may be easier to observe their color differences with a steadier image provided by a telescope. But here's a bonus. The open star cluster NGC 752 is right next to 56 Andromedae. Use this 6.3 magnitude star and draw a line from it through the 5.91 that's next to 56. On the other side is a 7.3 magnitude star, which is a foreground, unassociated one. It's centered in front of a very large open cluster that is nearly a full degree across. Use a long focal length eyepiece, and if possible, a shorter focal length telescope. This cluster contains stars about 9th magnitude and fainter, so if possible, use at least a 4.5-inch aperture telescope. One way to see a bit more here is to move your scope back and forth. The slight contrast difference of the dim stars stands out compared to the darker background area. It's a fantastic sight under darker skies. This week, look for free star charts at the homepage of eyesinthesky.com. On the 26th, Mercury and Saturn are less than a degree from each other, which has us literally looking across the solar system at the nearest planet and sixth planet. On the 27th, the Moon passes within 6 degrees of Mars and Leo. On the 29th, our natural satellite is near first magnitude Spica. For North America, the Moon will actually occult Spica around 1700 hours UTC, or the 12 o'clock hour Eastern Time, 9 a.m. Pacific. Why not see if you can observe an occultation in daytime? It is possible. See the blog at eyesonthesky.com for more info. And that's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.